Hello, welcome to Oracle Linux How-To video series. This video is to help you with configuration of KDEM on an Oracle Linux server. All steps and procedures explained and performed in this video are based on Oracle Linux Release 7. KDEM is the Linux kernel crash dump mechanism that allows us to save the contents of the system memory for analysis. Oracle recommends that you enable the KDEM feature as it helps Oracle Linux support to find the root cause whenever a server panics or crashes. In the event of a system crash, KDEM creates a memory image, also called the VM core, that can help in determining the cause of the crash. Enabling KDEM requires you to reserve a portion of system memory for exclusive use by KDEM. This memory is unavailable for other users. KDEM uses kexec to boot into a second kernel whenever the system crashes. Kexec is a fast boot mechanism which allows a Linux kernel to boot from inside the context of a kernel that is already running without passing through the bootloader stage. Prerequisites for KDEM are that the kexec tools package be installed on the server and a certain amount of memory be reserved for KDEM. This is for the kexec to boot into a secondary kernel. And a path be specified for memory dump to be stored, and it should have sufficient free space. It is also necessary that the KDEM service be running. KDEM mainly uses three files. The grub configuration file. This is where we specify the crash kernel parameter to reserve memory for KDEM. Next, the etc/kdem.conf file, which is the KDEM configuration file. This is where we set the location for storing the dump file and also the filtering level for core collector, which will be the makedump file command. And the default behavior to take if the dump fails. And it also relies on the kdump initramfs file, which will be present under the slash port directory. Let's see a quick demo on how to configure kdump and generate a dump from it. Firstly, we need to make sure that the kexec tools package is installed on the server. We see that it is not installed, so let's go ahead and install it. Now the package is installed. Next, we have to verify the crash kernel parameter, the grub configuration file. This is done via the etc default grub file since we are using grub 2. Here we set the crash kernel parameter and reserve a certain amount of memory for kdump. This value for crash kernel can either be auto or a specific amount of memory. We can see that it is set to 256M at an offset of 64M on the server. For larger servers with higher amount of physical memory, for example 128GB of physical memory, it is recommended to set crash kernel to 512M, and similarly for even larger servers, a higher amount of memory needs to be reserved for KDEM. Once the crash kernel parameter is added to the etc default grub file, the grub configuration file needs to be rebuilt. For that, we use the grub2-mkconfig command. We see that the grub entries for each installed kernel was updated. Let's see the grub configuration file. We see that the crash kernel parameter was added to the kernel entries in the grub configuration file. Once the grub configuration is updated, the server needs to be rebooted for the changes to take effect. I have already rebooted the server previously. Next, we have to configure kdump service, which is done via the etc/kdump.conf file. Here we see that the path parameter is set to var crash. This is the default path. This is used to specify the location for the memory dump to be stored. It is essential that the location have sufficient space. Next, the core collector needs to be configured, and we'll be using MacDump file as our core collector. For more details on the MacDump file, please refer to the manual page. The -d option is for the dump level parameter. Dump level specifies the necessary pages for analysis. These pages are not copied to the memory dump. The message level parameter is for setting the message types that need to be collected. Users can restrict outputs printed by setting the message level. Default value for message level is 7. Here we are setting it to 1. After making changes to the kdump configuration file, the kdump service needs to be restarted. While restarting the kdump service, the initramfs file is rebuilt to update the changes. It will be present under the /bot directory. Let's see the file. Here we see that the kdump initramfs file is generated. To ensure that the kdump configuration is proper and a VM core will be generated when the server crashes, we can trigger a manual crash of the server and verify that the dump is being generated. We do this by echoing a character C to the proc sysrq trigger file. Sysrq is a magic key, and these keys are a combination of keys which can be pressed, and the kernel will respond to it no matter whatever else it is doing unless it is completely locked up. Echoing a character C to the sysrq trigger file causes the server to crash by a null pointer dereference. Before triggering a crash, make sure that a downtime is available for the activity in case the server is a live production system. Let's crash the server. Now we are in the serial console of the server. We can see that the dump is being collected and that it has completed collecting it. Once the dump is collected, the server goes for a normal reboot. The time required to collect the dump varies based on the amount of memory that needs to be dumped. Now we see that it is rebooting and it is up now. Let's check the path where we had configured the dump to be collected. Let's check under var crash. We see that a directory with the timestamp was created. There are two files under it, that is the vmcore file and the vmcore tmsh file. We see that it is a data file and the size is considerably small, as this is a server with only 4 GB of memory. So we see that the kdump configuration was successful and a memory dump is generated. In case the server crashed at any time, you can be sure that the VM core will be generated. You can upload the VM core file to Oracle support for analysis. Here are some useful links and few My Oracle support knowledge documents. The knowledge can be accessed by logging into support.oracle.com. Please go through them for more information on kdump and known issues. That ends our short video on configuring kdump on an Oracle Linux server. Thank you for watching.